member of the president's cabinet pays a visit to Vermont Technical College. Good evening. I'm George Mallet.
I'm Stephanie Gorin. U.S. Labor Secretary Hilda Solis was in Randolph today, touring a dairy farm and meeting local students. She's here to highlight a new training program funded by the department, which aims to help more Vermonters qualify for available jobs.
Stuart Ledbetter was along for that tour today, and he now joins us live in the newsroom. Stu?
Well, Hilda Solis is a former congresswoman from a largely Hispanic district outside Los Angeles, seeing Vermont for the first time today and experiencing a few firsts.
I've never done this before. So.
Stepping off her bus at the VTC dairy farm in Randolph, U.S. Labor Secretary Hilda Solis tried to take it all in.
How about that, huh?
She got licked by an eager calf in the barn and saw how Vermonters make maple syrup in the spring.
But that's the boiler right there. Yeah.
But the real reason for her visit is because the Labor Department has just awarded Vermont Technical College a big grant, $3.4 million, to establish new training programs in agriculture and related industry, all tailored to the local job market.
What we know is that there are many employers looking for individuals with credentials that they can hire up quickly that will be able to get employed right away because the course offering, the curriculum, is also being driven by what the employers want.
Rachel Arsenault of Fairfax says it will fill a gap.
So the welding, for instance, is something I've always wanted to learn, and this is a great opportunity because it's really hard to find a place where you can actually learn how to weld.
The grant will also fund a new dairy processing facility here.
It will allow us to take our milk, put it into our own production plant, make our own products from fluid milk to butter to cheese to ice cream.
Hands-on training for both new students and those who have lost jobs or need to learn new skills. Solis said she'd not seen anything like this.
The president wants to see more people seeking credentials. That's where the biggest priority is for us right now, is to get people back to work.
This is a $2 billion program, by the way, and only about half of the money has been allocated so far. Solis hinting that more grants may be on the way in our region. VTC could not tell us how many students might benefit there over the next couple of years, but again, the key here is this partnership with area employers, designing training programs that you can sail through, in some cases, in a matter of months. In the newsroom tonight, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.